Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my channel. If you want to see the upcoming tutorials, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. This is the fifth episode about React and design. In this episode, we'll use the carousel and grid component to work on the hero section. First, let's create hero component. So open your code editor. Under components folder, create a new folder and call them home. And under this home folder, create a new file and call them hero.js. Let's make functional component, so add function hero. Inside return, let's add a div tag with a text hero. Then add export default hero. Now let's import this component under home component. So open home.js. On top, you can import hero from components slash home slash hero. Inside this div tag, add hero element. Also add a class called container in the div tag. Let's check the preview and we can see hero. It means our component is working. Now, if you look at the design, we got carousel on left hand side over here and information on the right. It means we have to use grid component. So open the site of React and Design, click Components, and click Grid. First thing to note here, it uses 24 grid system rather than 12 which most libraries use. Click on Responsive if you want responsive grid system, then click Show Code. The first thing we need to do over here is we have to copy this import of row and col. So on top, you can paste the import. Then we need to add row and col element. So inside this div tag, let's add row element. And inside row, let's add col element. Let's also add a class hero block in this div tag. In the col element, we can add the grid value. So over here, in the large device, I want to use grid value 18. And in this col element, I want to show carousel. So let's add carousel as a comment. Then I want to use another col element where I can show the information block. So add another col element. In large device, I want to use grid value 6. Now let's add carousel. So go back to React and Design website. On the left hand side, search carousel. We can see different example of carousel. For now, let's use the basic one. So click Show Code, click JavaScript. And first, you can copy the import of carousel. Then copy the carousel element. We don't need this afterChange attribute because it is calling onChange. And in onChange, we just have console log of the current slide. So we can just remove it. Also, we just got three slides, so remove one of the div. We need to show image instead of title. So if you go to the images folder, I want to import this banner image 1, 2, and 3. So on top, let's import image 1 from my assets / images / banner img1.jpg. Likewise, let's import image 2 and image 3 from banner-img2 and banner-img3. Now, instead of this h3 tag, let's add img tag. And inside the src attribute, let's add image 1. And in alt, let's just add banner 1. Let's show image 2. Then finally, let's show image 3. Let's take the preview now. And we can see the carousel over here. But currently, autoplay is not working. If you want to add autoplay, go to API, and all we need to do is, we need to add autoplay in the carousel element. So add autoplay. You can go back to the site, do the hard refresh, and you should notice autoplay is working now. Now, let's work on this information block. Open your code editor. Add div with a class called hero blocks. Inside this div, let's add another div with a class called holder. For icon, I want another div with a class icon. I can copy this icon using my developer tool. Copy and paste the icon over here. Then for content, let's create another div with a class called content. Copy the title and add them in h3 tag. Likewise, copy the subtitle and add them in p tag. Let's take the preview and we can see our first block. At the moment, we got minor issue, and that is, we don't have any space over here. So go back to grid component, click grid cursor, click show code, and in row element we can add gutter and a value. In this way we can add spaces in between the col element. So in row, let's add gutter. And in value, I want to add 24. Check the site now, and you should see a spacing over here. Now, let's add remaining two blocks. So, copy and paste this holder div. Copy this icon and replace it over here. Likewise, copy the title and subtitle and replace it in the holder div. Again, repeat the same process. Copy the icon. And replace them over here. Copy the title and subtitle. Then replace it over here. Once done, you can check the site. And this time, it is looking exactly the same as in the design. Great. This is the end of this session. In the next session, we'll use the grid and button component to work on recent products. Feel free to comment below if you have any question. Also, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to my channel to get more videos in the future. Thank you and see you soon.